Hello everyone, welcome to CyberScoop TV. Greg Otto, your managing editor here. We're coming to you from the floor of the 2019 Black Hat Conference. I'm talking with Rob Junker, the Senior Vice President of Research and Development for Code 42. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me, Greg.
So, your company specializes in backups, and with cities being attacked by ransomware, you obviously have a unique perspective on this. So, talk to me a little bit about what you're seeing when it comes to the need for backups in response to ransomware attacks.
You bet. And to first start off, we actually started in the backup space, but our business has been evolving as we think more and more about data loss protection. If you think about it, when organizations lose their data today, ransomware is one way in which that happens, which they need to be able to recover from. And in Code 42, we've focused on that. But we've expanded our targets to really focus more on the problem of data loss, if you will.
Okay.
Which includes things, for example, like organizations losing their data, whether it be from insider threat around issues, for example, like departing employees or other activities, malicious activities, or for that matter, user error, which can create some of those problems
of
that exist out there.
Okay.
But I think more in the world today, we've seen users be susceptible to attacks that cause individuals to lose their data and organizations to lose their data via insider threat and departing employees and other challenges. And the need for us to be able to manage that data loss is now more important than ever.
So, if I'm a small business, what do I do if I notice I have an employee that has left and has walked out with a couple thumb drives of data, or has, you know, deleted the work that they have been doing?
Well, one of the biggest problems is security technology has been focused a lot around prevention, where we talk about data loss prevention, where people are having to script really complex rules to control that behavior.
Okay.
When in reality, what we find is prevention, one, causes users not to be able to do their job, but second of all, it doesn't allow, if you will, organizations to think ahead of problems.
Okay.
So, as an example, if I'm a departing employee and let's say I decide to resign from an organization, in a lot of cases, I've taken the information with me that I want to travel with me, right?
Okay.
So what we focus on at Code 42 is bringing policy-free based data loss protection to the mix, which means that even if I needed to go back in time and research and say, for example, what files did Rob Junker exfiltrate to a USB drive, our software allows someone to go back in time, ask that question, regardless of whether or not they were in a policy or not, or regardless of not whether or not an organization was specifically looking for that kind of malicious activity.
So with data loss prevention and ransomware, we hear all the time that ransoms sometimes just need to be paid. Are you having conversations with your customers on what to do if they find the need to pay a ransom?
We definitely do, and every customer that we talk to needs to make their own independent decision at that point. But in most cases, especially when you talk about ransomware, the hacker is in control. They're the ones making the decision. The beauty of our solution, whether it be files that are on the endpoint or files in the cloud, Code 42 gives you the option and puts you back in the driver's seat to determine how you want to take steps to ultimately mitigate the problem that you're running into around ransomware. And we're finding, again, as we begin taking a look at threats, whether it be internal threats or external threats, more and more when hackers come in, whether it be by spear phishing or other attempts, what they're getting is the credentials of the logged-in user, the rights of that logged-in user. So as we continue to focus on those insider threats, it gives us the ability to see even those external threats that typically manifest themselves in an insider posture, if you will.
Okay. Finally, Rob, when we come to Black Hat, we talk about cybersecurity and we talk about the end user almost as like they're ephemeral.
Right.
And we don't really get to know what they're doing on a day-to-day basis. So I'm asking the experts that I talk to, what do you do on a day-to-day basis to protect yourself?
To protect myself as an individual, I tell you, first it comes with common sense, right? Making sure that I'm paying attention to the risks that I know, the vectors that I could be attacked by. But then at the same time, a big thing for me is making sure that you're paying attention to the basic best practices. Things like password rotations, making sure that you're using strong passwords in an environment, and then also working with our cybersecurity teams to make sure we've put together an ecosystem of tools that allows us to make sure that every user at Code 42 is protected as well. And then most importantly, and if you don't mind me saying so, all of those in the cybersecurity arena right now have a responsibility to evangelize those best practices with those that are around us. So many of the best practices we find today at Code 42 in terms of setting up insider threat programs, setting up programs for departing employees, or even setting up programs to make sure you're combating malware well, those are evangelizing best practices so that organizations really are able to take the control back in their own hands when issues do happen.
Great. Rob, appreciate your insight. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks again, Greg. Great having me.
For all of our videos, check out our YouTube channel. And for more on Black Hat and all things cybersecurity, check out cyberscoop.com. I'm Greg Otto. Thanks for watching.